Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to next topic on Kotlin Fundamentals, and we will start with another topic called as scoped functions or scope functions. If you look at the meaning of scope functions in official Kotlin documentation, this is what it says. Scoped functions are functions that execute a block of code within the context of an object. To put it simply, they are nothing but higher order functions. And which are those scope functions? They are let, run, with, apply, and also. If you look at how these are invoked, it is something that you are already familiar with. Typically, you have an object and then you use this scoped function, that is either let, run, with, apply, and or also. The syntax looks quite similar to a lambda. So this is something that you are already familiar with. But the next part is, what do you want to return and how do you want to access anything within this scoped function is crux of the matter. Right now, we will concentrate on what we are returning from the scoped function. You can either return a result or a object. This is basically the return type of your scoped function. These different scope functions that we have defined here return one of these things. For example, let, run, and with help you to return a result. Result is anything for that matter. It can be an object, it can be nothing also, it can be a unit. But with apply and also, you can return object only. It would be very difficult to make sense of this without having a look at the demo. So let's get into a demo. So I have created this file called as scoped functions demo. What I have done is nothing but created a let variable, and then I have initialized it with a person class, which is something that you might be already familiar with. If you have watched my previous videos, it has a first name, last name, nationality, and age. And then in front of that, I have written a scoped function, which is dot let. As of now, I have kept it very simple. I have kept it empty. And whatever that it is returning, I am assigning it to a let variable. And then I am printing it below. I have done same with run. I have done same with with. The syntax of with is slightly different. The way you do is you write a with block and then inside that you write this person object instantiation. And then you don't have to put the dot. It is directly the body of the higher order function. And once again, I am printing a variable. Same case with apply. And then in this case also. Everywhere the body of the scope function is empty. Now let's run this and see what happens. Pay attention now. Let, run, and with, they returned unit. Because I have not returned anything, they returned unit. So right now you can think of this as nothing but a result. However, with apply and also, I got a object, and that is what I was talking a moment earlier. Result can be anything. Unit is also a anything, which is not an object. With apply and also, you can only return the object. You cannot return a result. So having understood what is a return type, let's understand another concept. The concept is, once you have written this particular higher order function, that is scoped function, how are you going to reference object within the body of the scoped function? Either you can use it, which is a standard practice with any of the lambda functions, or do you want to use this within the body of the scoped function? This is called as context of the object or context reference of the object within the scoped function. And once again, depending upon which one you use here, certain things are allowed and certain things can't be used. So with respect to context of object, let and also allow you to use it. However, run, with, and apply only allow you to use this within the scoped function body. Once again, best way to understand this is through a demo. So let's get into a demo. So let's enhance this code to understand what do you mean by context reference. What I can do is, inside the body, how am I going to refer? With let, it is it dot first name plus, for example, it dot age. There is no meaning to it, but right now, imagine this is what I am writing within the let function. Let is nothing but it executes whatever the code that you want and it returns that. I can write exactly the same with also. And if I run this, you will observe that in let, instead of unit, it is assigning whatever the value that you are returning here. I can do the same here with run, but within run, I can't use it. I have to use this. The same is case with and also apply variable. And if I execute this, you will observe that let, run and with are basically initialized with strings. However, apply and also are still returning a object. That is the reason why I said apply and also always return the object, but let, run and with can return a result, and result can be anything. Can it be a object? Of course it can be an object. So what I can do is I can write it. So that is the object. In this case, I can write this, and in this case, I can write this. And in case of apply variable, once again, it is this. And here it has to be it. And now if I run this, you can observe that everything is returning a object, because these three things, that is let, run and with, can return anything. They can return object, they can return string, they can return whatever that you want to return. But in case of apply and also, you always return an object. So let me show you something here. This dot first name is equal to this dot first name dot reversed. Val cannot be reassigned. I think this first name is of val type. So I think instead of first name, I will use nationality. Nationality dot reversed. It is of nullable type. And I can do the same in also, but instead of this, I have to use it. And if I run this, nationality got reversed. So if you want to basically update the contents of a object, modify it and return the same object, then you use apply and also. Another thing is, in case of let, run and with, you can return anything. Say for example, it dot first name, it dot age. And if you want to make it even more explicitly readable, you can write return let. In the same way, I can write return run and then this dot first name. This dot first name is just unnecessary. You can write just first name plus age, and then here you can write return with first name age. And if I run this, you will see that let, run and with are being initialized with strings because they can contain result. Now the question is, can I return apply? Of course you can write return apply, but you can't return anything here. If you try to do that, it will give a compilation error. Now let me write return apply this. Even that also you cannot write. If at all you are using return apply, don't write anything. Otherwise, no need to write anything at all, because anyhow it is always going to return an object. And in the same way, return also, can I write it? No, it is a compilation error. Can I write anything here which is a string? No. Once again, it always returns an object. You cannot return anything. So you cannot return anything other than an object, and you cannot write anything in front of the return also. So you can either keep it empty or don't write it at all.
We have covered a pretty good ground here. The remaining part will be explained in the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.